Hi, welcome back. Certainly glad you could join us today because today we're going to have just a fantastic time.
Just kidding, JK friends. Okay, on to business.
Hello again, JK friends, and welcome back to Recess with Miss Cox. But as you can see, today I teamed up with Mr. Howe to bring you some extra special projects. That's right, the first part of today's recess, you had a chance to listen to Mr. Howe read one of my favorite books, Mix It Up. And you can probably already figure out why this is one of my favorite books to read. It's because it's about art. Oh, yes. JK friends, I love talking about colors, talking about paint, and talking about mixing colors and mixing paint. And that is what we get to do at recess today. So, hang with me. We are going to be doing three amazing, beautiful, colorful projects today during recess that all have to do with the ideas that were shared in the book, Mix It Up. The first thing we're going to be doing today is making a color wheel. If you've never heard of what this is, don't worry. Today is the day you find out if you do know what this is. Fantastic. Use your artist brain, wake it back up, and we'll remind you of some things you may already know about colors and how they're made. Number two, we get to talk about black and white. Are they colors? What do they do to other colors? Can something that's black and white be colorful? All of these questions will get answered maybe today during this video. And finally, the third thing we're going to do, there are some pages in the book Mix It Up that I love the art that is on those pages, and I thought it would be an interesting idea to take some time and recreate the artwork that is in the book. Now, I don't know if you can remember this, but there's a special word for the artwork that goes inside of books. Do you remember what it is? I'll give you a second to think about it. Ready to hear the word? Artwork that's inside of a book is called illustration. If you've heard of someone being an illustrator, guys, if you have one, we've talked about illustrators in class, then kiss your brain, because it looks like you guys get to be illustrators today as we recreate art from this book. So without further ado, let's get ready to mix it up. Like I said, JK friends, the very first thing we're going to be doing today is creating a color wheel. Now, there's a couple of things you're going to need to make a color wheel. First of all, wheels are round, and sometimes circles can be a hard shape to draw. Now, there are special tools that'll help you draw a circle, but I'm gonna trace mine because I'm real persnick. It means I really, really like things to look a certain way. I do everything for the aesthetic, JK friends, what can I say? So I'm going to trace my circle with this. I am also not gonna trace it the first time in pen because that could get messy, so I have a pencil. I am also obviously going to need some paper. And when we really start mixing up these colors, I'm gonna need paint. And for most of this, I'm going to be using my fingers for mixing paint. But for actually putting it on our color wheel, I'm gonna use paint brushes. And you know what? I might even just use a pen or a Sharpie like this to help divide the colors and make it look nice and pretty when we're done. But those are all the things I'm going to use to make this color wheel. Let's get started on it. You can see all the supplies I talked about. And I'm gonna start out by taking this candle lid, yes, that's what this is, the candle lid, and tracing a circle for my color wheel. I'll outline it so you guys can see it a little bit better. I'm also gonna divide this circle into six equal pieces. There are going to be six colors on this color wheel, so I need them all to have a home.
I went ahead and labeled three of these places because instead of painting all six colors at once, we're going to paint our primary colors first. Now, you guys already know this, but the primary colors are red, blue, and yellow. Primary colors are important because without these three colors, you won't be able to create any other colors. Now it's time to move on to these blank spaces. The spaces we left are for secondary colors. You may be thinking, what is a secondary color? Well, I'll tell you. You get a secondary color when you mix two primary colors together, like red and blue. When you mix them together, they make this purple. Purple is our first secondary color. How about yellow and blue? Yellow and blue mixed together make green. Green is our second secondary color. And that leaves red and yellow. And you guys know that when red and yellow get together, they make, what do you think? Yep, orange. All right. Now that our color wheel is all the way filled in, you probably notice that there are colors that are across from each other on the color wheel. These colors are called complementary colors, and they are really striking, or in other words, they make a big wow when they are used together. So a lot of places like schools or sports teams, maybe even holidays or countries, use these as their colors. For example, yellow and purple are used by the LSU Tigers, a college from where I'm from. Red and green are in the Mexican flag, and blue and orange, you guys know, are the colors of the Chicago Bears. Do you guys know any other groups that use complementary colors in their designs? I would love to know which ones you can think of.
JK friends, we made a beautiful color wheel. Now you may have noticed there are some colors that were in the book Mix It Up that we haven't talked about yet. Two that I'm thinking of are black and white. Now JK friends, you know this about me, but nearly everything I have is black and white. I honestly, and most of the time, some of you even asked me this when we were in our classroom, you said, Miss Cox, what's your favorite color? And I would always say the same phrase. And I know it may have sounded a little crazy at the time, but everything I say, for the most part, has a reason behind it. And when you guys asked me my favorite color, I always said, if black was a color, it would be my favorite color. But black is actually a value. Black is just a dark, 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 dark shade of one of the colors on the color wheel. So my actual favorite color is green, but if black were a color, my favorite color would be black. And today you get to find out why that is my really long-winded explanation for that. Now, JK friends, not everybody has the brain of an artist like you and I do. Not everyone has that. So you can understand these deep concepts and ideas about values and shades and color theory that some other people don't have the opportunity to. So latch on to this and always remember what you're about to discover about what black and white do to the colors on the color wheel.
Here's our completed color wheel. Well, I say completed, But really, phase one is completed, because now it is time to play with black and white. Now, JK friends, when you add black to a color, it's like taking all the light out. It looks just like this. The opposite, if you keep adding white to a color, it brightens all the way up until it looks like this. So, all that black and white do is make darker, 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 or lighter, 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 shades of colors that we've already made on our color wheel. So let's go ahead and mix white in with each of these colors and see how it changes the way that they look. Section of our color wheel is definitely much lighter, but the colors still kind of look the same. Let's see what happens if we mix our color wheel colors in with a little bit of black. What our colors look like when you add white and black to them. Remember, the more you add of each of those colors, the bigger difference it makes.
And finally, JK friends, we are moving on to one of my favorite parts of recess today, which is we are going to recreate a piece of artwork and illustration from the book Mix It Up. Now, JK friends, go ahead and lift your hand into the air. Take a good look at it. There was a page at the beginning of the book where we had to hold our hand down on all the colors to make them appear. And it actually looked like, in this picture, like maybe your hand is taken off the page. And there's an artistic word for this. It's called negative space. Can you say negative space? Awesome. Negative space is when a picture is made not by coloring it in, but by coloring everything around something and then taking it away. Not sure what that means? Don't worry. We're gonna explore it more as we make this project.
This is a fun painting that anybody can do. This is a good one. If it's your first or second painting, this is wonderful.
To start this illustration, I'm going to make a quick tracing of my hand. And then I'm going to cut it out. Next, I'm going to tape my hand that I cut out down to a new sheet of paper. And finally, for all the colors, I am going to paint dots of all these colors all over this paper. You'll notice I'm definitely using my fingers to paint right on top of the edges of the hand that I cut out. That's because that cutout is going to stay on our painting. I know. It's there now, but it's going to look different when we take it away later. So go ahead and add all the colors that you want to your masterpiece. dry, we can peel off this hand to see our creation.
JK friends, thank you so much for joining me in the studio today for these artistic adventures. I hope that you enjoyed reading the book Mix It Up. I hope that you learned a little bit more about color theory and how artists mix all these colors together to create illustrations that you enjoy. And I hope that you had a good time recreating an illustration with me today. If you haven't tried it yet, go ahead and find some supplies and try it on your own. You can make all kinds of things using negative space in your art, and I hope that it's a trick you might use when you're creating in the future. Thank you so much for joining me for this creative afternoon, and I hope you have a wonderful day in your own artistic studio at home. Bye-bye.